Red Sparrow is now in theaters everywhere. And enough with that. That's not my best accent. But guys, Red Sparrow, like I said, is in theaters. It is directed by Francis Lawrence, who directed the last three Hunger Games movies, I Am Legend, Constantine. He is an okay director, in my opinion. I think the only film that I was, like, really, really a fan of was Catching Fire. The rest were either okay or slightly above average. So I went into Red Sparrow with kind of low expectations, because the premise is basically that Jennifer Lawrence's character gets recruited by this organization where they basically they use their bodies and they are trained in the art of basically killing people for the government in order to obviously help the government with things. This film received mixed reviews, and having seen the film, I can understand why, because I feel mixed about this film, so much so that I didn't really like it. I liked it to a fault, and I'll say that by I was engaged with some scenes, and then other scenes I just felt kind of led, not nowhere, but that they didn't really enhance the plot, because this film is trying to be a character-driven story. It really is. The problem is, we've seen pretty much all of this stuff happen in other espionage-type films. Done better, too. I mean, I wasn't a huge fan of Salt, but for what it was solid. And Red Sparrow took some stuff from Salt, like, surprisingly a decent amount of stuff. You know, where you're wondering if the protagonist is, you know, if she's with the Russians, or if she actually is in love with Joel Edgerton's character, like, we don't know. I mean, the film kind of, at the end, answers it, but it's just, there. It was intrigue for intrigue's sake. It didn't lead up to really anything, and it wasn't really done for artsy purposes. It was done for, like, this is it kind of purposes. But I will say this, Jennifer Lawrence was really good in the film. The score by James Newton Howard was engaging. It helped enhance a lot of the scenes. Not a great score, but, like, again, for what it was, it did its job. The film is shot well. Yeah, very gloomy, but, it makes sense due to the tone of the film. But I just think that this film was kind of bogged down by so many cliches, and instead of stripping away those cliches and trying to do something new, it kind of felt like the same old espionage stuff of, who can you trust, like, type deal. And it's a shame, because Red Sparrow, it did have potential. But Red Sparrow gets a 2.5 out of 5-star rating from me. Again, I think that if you like this film, that is completely fine. I can understand. But again, at 2 hours and 20 minutes, I just felt like it just was going for the intrigue, and it wasn't going for the satisfaction of the audience or keeping the audience in the loop. I mean, I will say this, I'm glad this film wasn't spoon-feeding anything by any means, but I do kind of wish that this film kind of had something going for it other than just intrigue and not, like, getting to the end with answers. You know, you can only have intrigue for so much longer. But, guys, that's my review for Red Sparrow. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And did you like it? Did you not? Let me know in the comment section down below. And as always, guys, thank you very much for watching. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Catch you guys later.